Hello friends, Srinivas here. Welcome to our channel. Today I'm going to show the general approval process in Oracle Fusion. What are the prerequisite setup required for enabling general approval, and how we can use BPM workflow to create and write general approval rules as per our specific business requirement. So let us start. So let us go to my Excel sheet and show you the scenario. So this is my business requirement, and accordingly I am writing my conditions for journal approval. So I'm creating journal for my primary ledger, that is US primary ledger, and journal source is manual. For journal batch the approval should be enabled, and the amount is another condition, where if the amount is less than 1001, it should be auto approved. If the amount crossing that 1001 threshold, it will go to supervisor for approval. So this is my business conditions, and I'm going to write this condition in BPM workflow. So let us see. So before starting the writing the approval rules, so this is the prerequisite setup required to enable journal approvals. One at primary ledger level, where we need to enable that checkbox, approval checkbox, and another for the specific journal approval, journal sources for which you are creating journal, the approval should be enabled there. So these are the two prerequisite setup. Let me go to system and go to my implementation project. So my implementation project is Shrini, and I want to search for the tags called specify ledger option. In specify ledger option, I need to enable the approval checkbox in my ledger. So you can see here in journal processing section, so this checkbox should be enabled. So I have enabled the enable journal approval checkbox, save and close. And the next thing is source. In journal source, I need to check for the source manual, the approval should be enabled. So let me search for the manual, because I'm going to create manual journal. And you can see here require journal approval is enabled. So these are the two prerequisites you need to check. So next thing is go to the BPM workflow and see and write the approval rules as per our business requirement. So let me go to approval workflow, BPM workflow screen. And just click on manage approval group tags. From there I can go to BPM workflow and select my role, manage approval group. From that click on tags configuration, and here in the left hand side you can see tags to be configured. There are so many shaded approval rule set has been provided by Oracle as per the module, and in our case we have to select the journal approval rules. Okay, so we can select this, and accordingly we can modify our rule as per our business requirement. So that is Finance GL General Approval. Just click on that. So here go to Assignee tab. In Assignee tab, you can see there are so many roles has been defined, and like serial, parallel, and job level, position level approval rule sets. So you have to select which one you need for your business. So I'm selecting for the time being the serial type approval roles. So that is basically the supervisory approval. Just select on the go to rule tab, that is a blue spot here. Just click on that go to rule icon. It will drive you to that rule. Okay. We have to edit this rule as per our specific conditions and scenario. So what is your first condition? So our condition is that we are creating journal for US primary ledger, journal sources manual, and for the ledger and journal batch, the approval button should be enabled. And the amount is, if it is less than 1001, it should be auto approved. If it is more than 1001, it should go to supervisor of that journal creator. So that is our rule. So how we can translate this into the BPM workflow rule? So I have written this rule. You can see here the first rule is for auto approval. The first condition is journal batch. For the journal batch level, the approval should be enabled. That means it is yes, the first condition. And the journal batch ledger name is US primary ledger. Okay. So my ledger is US primary ledger. Third condition is for amount. The amount is less than 1001. What it will do? First person is condition. Then I am selecting the supervisory approval rule. So that is list builder is supervisory. Response type is required. Number of level is 1. Okay. But as the condition, as per the condition, the auto action is enabled. That means is the amount is less than 1001, auto action, it should be approved automatically. So that is my first approval rule. Okay. So let me create one journal and see if it is working perfectly or not. So let me navigate to General Accounting Journal. And create journal. My journal batch name is Demo 5. And my ledger name is US primary ledger. Category is manual. So you can see here at batch level, I have one condition, that is approval status. It should be yes. So you can see here approval is required. Second, ledger name is US primary ledger. So two of the conditions has been fulfilled. Now third condition, we have to select the amount. Okay. So just create the accounting string. So that is cash. So my amount is 500, that is less than 1001. Let me go to credit line and complete the credit entry. Okay. So let me save this and complete. So once I complete, I need to post this. During posting, it will ask for the approval. And you can see here the journal require approval before posted, and it has been forwarded to the approver. But it will not go for any approval because as per our condition, it should be auto-approved. So just go to the notification bar. We should be able to see that approval workflow notification here. Okay, so approved. So journal batch is auto approved. So within a fraction of second, it should be approved automatically. Just wait for some times. The approval status is changed now to approved. So that means our auto approval rule set is working. Now let us go for second condition. So our second condition is the amount is more than 1000, it will go for supervisor for approval. Again, let me show you that condition, how it is written in BPM workflow. So this is the rule, US primary ledger manager approval rule. The first two condition will be same, like journal batch approval status should be yes. Journal batch ledger name is US primary ledger, but here the amount is more than 1000. Okay, so it should list builder is supervisory approval, and the starting participant, it is nothing but the journal creator. Top participant is the principal or the manager of the journal creator. The number of level is one, that means it will go for one level of approval. So once the journal creator will submit the journal, it will go for his manager. If the manager is approving, so it will end the approval workflow. Auto action is false, that means auto action is not enabled for this condition because it will go for approval as the amount is more than 1000. Okay, so now let us create that one journal with more than 1000 and see if this rule is working or not. Create journal. My journal name is Demo 6. My ledger is US primary ledger, category is manual. Same conditions. Only we are going to change the journal amount. Journal line amount, so that should be more than 1000 as per our second condition. I'm selecting here 1020, so that is more than 1000. I have given my debit line and credit line, accounting string. That's all. Let me save and complete the journal and try to post it. While posting it, it will ask for approval. Okay, so journal require approval. So now it should go to my immediate manager. So my manager is Kelvin Roth said, "This is my supervisor. It will not be auto-approved, so let me log out of Srini IMP and log into the manager of Srini IMP, that is Kelvin Roth. Sign out." So I am logging into the Kelvin Roth. I should be able to see the approval notification in his login, so that he will be able to approve this. You can see here the journal badge demo 6 is pending for approval, and just click on approve. So now the tax is done. Again, I am logging out of manager Kelvin Roth and log into the Srini IMP. Go to general accounting, journal, and search for my journal. Go to manage journal. So now the approval status of the journal should be approved. You can see the approval status is approved. The batch status is posted. So this way you can write the business rule for our general approval process. First we need to write these conditions, business requirement, in a paper, and that we need to translate into the BPM workflow, and then we need to test all these conditions in the journal creation. So that's all, guys. Thank you for watching this video. And if you have any questions, you can comment in the comment sections. And if you have not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and click on the bell button to get the latest updates. Thank you, guys.